hardly healed scars will tear open again when suspected perpetrators of the devastating terrorist attacks in Paris in 2015 will have to appear in court next week. Survivors and relatives of the 130 victims should be given adequate space in the process. It will be a process that breaks practically every framework in terms of organizations, process and content. Almost 6 years after the devastating Islamist terrorist attacks in Paris with 130 dead and 350 injured, the proceedings against 20 suspects will begin on Wednesday next week, and Salah Abdeslam, who has already been convicted in Belgium and is considered to be one of the main perpetrators, is among them. At the highest level of security, especially formed Paris jury will negotiate against suspected members of the terrorist cell. Even before it began, the process was tearing open old wounds in France, which was quite traumatized by the night of terror. On November 13th in 2015, a Friday, extremists caused a massacre in the Parisian concert hall Bataclan, where they shot 90 people and shot at bars and restaurants in the east of the capital. In total, the attackers killed, as I said, 130 people in the attacks at various locations in Paris. In addition, three suicide bombers blew themselves up at the Stade de France during the international soccer match France against Germany. The terrorist militia Islamic State, the IS, claimed the attacks as their actions. For the V13 procedure, V stands for Vendredi, Friday, which has also been announced as the litigation of the century, a new hall made of light wood has been moved into the Paris Palace of Justice for a limited period of time. Screens ensure that the negotiation is broadcast in all areas of the hall, and psychological support is available for those affected throughout the entire process. Because the night of terror is not only approaching again in words, a sound recording of the attack on the Bataclan could also be played. In view of the dramatic extent of the night of terrorism, the victims and their relatives are given the space they deserve. Over 5 weeks, around 300 of them are supposed to describe what they have experienced. Half an hour each is given. 14 such statements per day are planned for the trial. Those involved in the process are facing a marathon, also in terms of emotional processing and immersion in what is happening. The first questioning of the defendants is only planned afterwards. According to the Public Prosecutor's Office, there are 1,765 co-plaintiffs. At the start of the trial, 2 days are reserved for calling everyone by name. Only on the third day does the court want to deal more broadly with the content of the allegations, which are based on 500 files full of investigation results. Hundreds of witnesses have been summoned, including investigators from France and Belgium, and even then-President François Hollande, it is said. 12 of the 20 accused face life imprisonment. 6 of them are tried in absentia. Before the trial began, reports with harrowing details dragged the French back into the traumatic night of terror. The station France Info published audio recordings from the Paris Emergency Call Center for the first time. I saw a guy with a Kalashnikov who got out of a car and just shot people at McDonald's, said one of the callers. My husband and I were shot at the Bataclan. We are injured. I'm not feeling well, says a woman's voice. There are at least 4 people injured and we can still hear gunshots, she said. Engineer Gregory, whom the terrorists in the Bataclan took hostage with others as a human shield and hostage, described to the France Inter station how one of the perpetrators asked him to get up and he grabbed his backpack. Why are you taking your things? You don't need them anymore. You will die, the man snapped at him. Meanwhile, from the balustrade, the terrorists aimed at visitors who wanted to escape from the concert hall. They propped themselves up on their elbows for time to aim, then shot down anyone who moved below, Gregory said. The extent to which the process will bring new knowledge to the background and the puppet players of the Night of Terror also depends on whether the accused are even ready to testify. Initially, the process is scheduled until May next year. Regardless of the outcome of the trial, France will not be able to shake off the shadow of Islamist terrorism anytime soon, as lone perpetrators, mostly with knives, have recently shaken the country. When President Emmanuel Macron insists on the fight against terrorism, as he did during his recent visit to Iraq, this is by no means an empty phrase for the French. And I'll see you in my next video. Bis gleich.